Most anticipated film of the summer. Please be good. Hello once again, watchers of good movies. My name is Nick Pell, and this is once again coming from my apartment. Now today we are going to be talking about the film Valerian and the City of a Thousand Planets. Now, apparently this is based on a comic series, which I've never heard of, honestly, called Valerian and Lorelei. Those are the two main characters of this film. We have Dane DeHaan playing Valerian, we have Cara Delevingne playing Lorelei. And one thing which I really liked about this film is their chemistry. They work really well together as actors, and when they had interactions on screen, they were very flirtatious, and I really appreciated that. And I thought that it worked really, really naturally, and it flowed really well. The film also starts out really interestingly as well, because you get to see the creation of the City of a Thousand Planets, which is essentially this massive space station, which just continues to grow over the years, as first all of the Earth's nations came and joined onto it, and then eventually alien life came and joined onto it, and eventually just thousands of planets eventually became a part of it. And so we have this giant space station, which is home to millions of life forms. As far as I can tell, a lot of this film is CGI and green screen, and it looks amazing, honestly. There are multiple different creatures which are in the film, which create just a lot of comedy in certain situations. I was laughing a lot at certain things in this film. The opening sequence for this film, where we get to see kind of a prologue before we meet our main characters, just looks gorgeous, because it's all CGI, all green screen. We get to see this alien life, just this paradise planet, essentially, and what ends up befalling it before meeting DeHaan and Cara Delevingne. And just looks fantastic. And so this film is made with an over $200 million budget. And you can tell that a lot of it was used for the CGI and green screen effects for this film. And again, it looks fantastic. This is one of the best CGI green screen looking films that I've seen, because again, looks amazing. Thankfully, it also has a pretty interesting story for the most part. Again, like I said, we can see this prologue of this paradise planet in the beginning, and that continues to play a role throughout the course of the rest of the movie. And it's really interesting to see how that ends up connecting to our present day story, as we have Valerian and Lorelei going on this secret mission that they don't really know a lot about, and then just more things are revealed over the course of the film. So I really did like those aspects of this film. I did have some issues with it, unfortunately. One thing is the dialogue, because I feel like a lot of the dialogue is picked directly out of the comic. Again, haven't read the comic. I have no way to verify that as now, but just some things which were said just seemed very comic book-y, in that they would work in a comic book because you can put your own little spin on it in your head as you're reading it, but when it's just put on the screen and just focalized, it doesn't really work as well in some cases. The film also gets a little bit slow after a point. It kind of has the same issue that I had with Sausage Party, if for those that have seen that, where it just kind of slows down and goes into a section for about 20 minutes or so that didn't necessarily need to be there for the sake of the story. It just kind of adds to the runtime, which is over 2 hours as it is. And it also introduces a character who is introduced and then taken out of the film within that half hour chunk of time. And that's really kind of disappointing, because it's like, why were they introduced in the first place if they're not really going to be essential to the plot at all? But this is one of the issues when you're trying to adapt a comic book or a manga or anything of that sort to the big screen, to a film, to a TV show, to anything like that, because you are going to have these little side stories, side adventures, which might add things to the audience who is going to read and digest that material on paper. But when you have it on the screen, it just takes up time from the main plot and just ultimately slows the film down. It's really unfortunate. And I hate to say this as well, but I felt the film wrapped up a little too cleanly for my taste. As far as I know, they want to launch this as a new IP, a new series, saga, or something. But it just kind of wraps up so swimmingly well for everyone involved for the most part that it's like, yeah, I guess there's not really any consequences or stakes for a lot of this. So guys, ultimately, I had a fun time watching Valerian. It's something new which I was able to be introduced to. I'm definitely interested in reading the comics now, if they're still in circulation to some degree. But while the film looks gorgeous, again, CGI green screen effects look fantastic. Best I've ever seen, probably. And the chemistry between the main actors works really, really well. Dane DeHaan, Cara Delevingne work really well together. And it has an interesting enough story. There's just enough things which will weigh it down, which really just falter it and make it not quite as good as it maybe could have been. But guys, those are my thoughts on Valerian and the City of a Thousand Planets. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Did you like it as much as I did? Did you hate it more than I did? Let me know. Thank you for your comment and subscribe once again if you so choose. I'd appreciate it immensely. And as always, my people, my name is Nick Pell. And once again, keep on watching.